Not a huge chip lead anymore. Paul has also a bunch of chips, but then lots of middling, 2 million stacks. These two guys have pretty good stacks as well. Should be a fun one. We start in the big blind with queen check off, pretty decent hand. We see a limp. Should definitely raise a hand as good as this. He's gonna have a lot of hands that he limp calls that I'm head against. If he goes for a limp raise, we could just see a flop as well. Riots, okay. Just trying to get some more information on the guys. Sharks are great run when we have three tables left because they don't have that many call attacks on Party Poker yet. Oh shit, Instagram. Instagram.com/Bolero, guys. It's literally the best way to stay up to date. I'm a big fan of Instagram now. Easy with the stories, some behind the scenes stuff. Shit, guys, we're live again. Fired up two Twitch streams in a row now. 1-9 bounty, 2.5k plus bounty up top, so 5k plus. Chip leader, let's get it. I'm the 10-5-0 on the button here, chip lead on the final table. Let's try to put some pressure on. We also have a recreational player in the big blind. So pretty happy to take a post flop against him. Come on, chat. There we go. Ooh, comes in with the 3-bet. He wins this one. He seems a bit aggressive. Cheers, Poker Zwiebel. We go for another one, even though we just got 3-bet. Kennst du das, wenn du übertrieben blau bist, trotzdem austrinkst? Henning, kennst du das? Yeah, definitely. When you're super drunk and you keep on drinking, sure. Gotta finish the class, dude. I mean, it's 5-minute blinds. This is definitely a turbo. You feel it. Don't think this is a flop where we get check raised too often. Probably flats too wide from the small blind. Yeah, okay, it's. It just sucks so hard if you get raised. I'm gonna check it. It's pretty close. Yeah, DD is New Zealand yet. He fired up a session earlier. I'm not sure why when he returns to streaming. I want to ask him that yesterday, but forgot. We can ask him on break, okay? Now I'm just gonna try to get to show him with my 10. Hope he has like 7 sixes. Big blind obviously has really wide range still. Nice. Could have also just called. Thought I might have as well turned my hand into bluff and fold out some hands and won a value bet there. How tilting is it when you lose a big hand in a very short stack right before break? Still much better than making 82 when you're not in the money yet and have to come back in the bubble. But they're slightly annoying, I would say. Wrong table hype. Some things never change. Wrong table, yeah. Jeff Groves stuff, wrong table, 5 minutes of lobby hype. I mean, Jeff Groves is on another level, okay? I'm bad with the wrong table, I give you that. But Jeff Groves is just on a different level. Like, at least I'm showing you the wrong table where there's still action. It's different than showing the fucking poker lobby, I mean. Come on. Also, I'm a retired streamer at this point. Oops, what did you post? I don't know what you posted. Oh, Gucci. We just don't want to see random links in the channel. I'm not sure with how many. You start with a $40 bounty or something. So we made $800 in bounties. So, like, over $1,000 here already. It's nice. After my 27k bink on party, I was just pricking everything. So it's kind of nice to. Whew, that's value. I mean, that. We're saying he has a queen or nothing. But he only has the queen. He never has anything else there. Especially because I think they did they check it down or something? Because then the guy has infinite queen x as well with queen jack, queen 10. I mean, not infinite, I guess. Still plenty. Plenty. Fun. The good thing of raising 10-9 is also that the guy behind me could fold like some queen 10, king 10 hands. Which is the downside. Like, that's the thing that puts me in an awkward spot there with the 10-9 when I call. Because Paul suddenly calls like some queen checks or so. But if I raise it, he's like he's just caught in this awkward spot and folds a lot of hands, right? So like if he were heads up or something, he needs that river, I can just call. But with him still in the pot, it's just so much more tempting to raise. Which is also the issue just with calling the 10-9. Because he's still in there. If I know he never has a better hand, then it's quite an easy call. But yeah. GRG, I was on your table a few times today, yeah. Nice. Hope you had a good session. But, by the way, I seen my doctor yesterday. It's so I had to leave him at stream. He very happy with my one this evening. Well, that's awesome, dude. That was a fucking journey, dude. Nice to be back to proper health. That was fucked, dude. That was literally the most fucked up thing. Like, KB was in the hospital for 3 months, I think. At least 3 months. I was always like, oh, he's about to get out. And there was another issue with his wound. Fucking insane. Like, literally insane. Happy that he made it, mate. I'm not sure, like, I never really told you guys about that, but I posted this thing on Discord, like, a couple of weeks ago, because my grandpa was, like, in really bad condition, and I was, like, the first, like, little time I didn't want to stream, even though I had my setup here, because I was just a bit sad there. I thought I said my final goodbyes to him, and then, like, 2 days later, he had, like, the sickest, like, he had a really, really sick recovery, and right now he's at home, and it's, like, 3 weeks later, and he's actually in pretty decent condition. It's pretty unreal. I thought I said my final goodbyes, but now he's home and still alive. So we definitely got a lot of run good off the field there. I literally skyped and I was like, man, that was the last time I see you, but got lucky there. Alright, let's see. Queen 6 for folding. It's getting kind of warm in here. Probably should open up the window soon. For the labels, like, this is just, I'm not really sure what this guy is. These guys are recreationals, probably. I mean, he made some regular moves now, but it's pretty active generally. Regular, probably regular, and regular. That's the tournament is fast. Why are people so deep? I mean, the tournament has been running for 4.5 hours, and we want to find a table. For party poker, this is a really quick structure, because if he had a similar tournament with the normal party structures, we would be playing for 8 hours, so like 7 hours to get to this point, 6-7 hours, I would say. So it's definitely faster than the normal structures. Compared to PokerStars, it's actually just a normal tournament, I would say. Got an easy fold. That was a quick 3-bet over there. Just press the pot button or something. Will you love me forever? Do you need me? I was listening to Queen Life at 8. Best version. While watching Super Hyrule Bone on break. That was good stuff. Weeks in the hospital. Yeah, it's roughly over 3 months. Wolfman, glad you're doing okay. Yeah, that was fucked up, man. It was obviously, like, not funny, but interesting to, like, sweat the whole thing. It's like, oh, they need me, like, for another couple of weeks here. Oh, nice river race. Cheers, Jamie. Thanks, Lennon Place. What a beast. Cheers, boys. I mean, I had the best hand when I raised the 10-9, I'm fairly sure. Yeah, true, Thomas. Since, like, the blind levels. I mean, they have so many random blind levels. Like, look, there's 42, 84, 46, 92, 50, 100. Then things are more normal. But they have, like, some fucked up 1875, 37.5k blind level. Alright. What are your value hands when you check twice at raise river? Mostly low flushes that I check twice there. Some queen. I have to see a river again. Pocket threes. And let's see. As I said, like, part of the reason that raising there is so amazing is that the reason, like, usually I would love calling there, but The reason that that call gets pretty dicey is just because the small blind, when he flats me, still has better hands that he checks on the river like three times, right? So with the raise, we just fold that out, and then it doesn't even matter that much what I'm representing here, because we think that he bluffs, and we should have a profitable raise against that range, and then we're doing good enough against that. And then he doesn't really think that much, is what I expect, and we just get a lot of folds from him, so we don't have to worry about him overcalling with Queen 10. But yeah, there's definitely enough value hands for me to that I want to raise in the river there sometimes. That's an easy decision. I mean, if you want to go for a pot lead there, that's okay with me. Just have to fold our ace check, easy decision. And next time I have my ace king there, he's gonna get stacked. Life run good is the real run good, I agree. It's easy to just get caught up in the poker moment and not really appreciate things. This is the nice thing about this grind spot. Yesterday when I was playing, there was like a bunny sitting right next to the fence for 2 hours. Just a wild bunny, and he was so cute, just eating there and just chilling. And I was like, man, like, it makes you appreciate things. Like, who the fuck cares about a fucking bad beat, dude? We will never understand what running good or bad really means, right? It's like the old story with the farmer. I know. Pretty much about, we never know if something is good or like if something is lucky or unlucky, right? We can only see like such a brief moment of our entire life, of the entire universe or whatever. Only kind of run good I have, gamble so bad. Don't gamble. I mean, I guess you're running good in the sense that your life run good is really good, and your grind run good is not that good. That's also run good. Lul, Yoti Gould, what gold? Whatever. What up, dude? Cheers. Honestly, I love doing this. This is like my favorite type of streaming. Quick, so it doesn't take that much energy away from me. High pressure moments where we're playing for lots of money, and you guys enjoy money. You guys enjoy the fine table hype. Like, nobody wants to see me 15 tabling, 80 big blinds deep. And this way I can give you guys all the interesting moments. It's not that exhausting for me, so I can play more poker, play more tables, and therefore create more deep runs. I get the satisfaction of actually living a normal MTT grinder life, while still having interesting streams for you. Thought you were unlucky last night in FD. Hopefully better result tonight. I hope so too. I don't want to finish 7th here. We'll see what happens. Yeah, I mean, I could have made a different decision with the ace-5 there. I don't think it's like super unreasonable. That's also not amazing. Oh, these are some quick 3-bets, man. Yeah. It's alright. To finish 7th out of 1,600 runners is pretty good. Cheers, Redeem J. Ooh, the 4-bet jam. Now we're gambling. Boring. God, would have won it all. Why did I fold? Limit you post things. I just had a question. I was watching the other day playing on the .es version of PokerStars and the .com version. How do you do that? You just go to PokerStars.es, download the client, and then make an account there. That's how you do it. The thing is, like, with PokerStars, if you go to their website, it might redirect you to your country's website. Then you just need to look, like, just Google how to get the .es download version or something. How to download PokerStars.es, and maybe it gives you the download link or whatever. Wasn't that tough for me, to be honest. To this guy. Easy open with the King 9. I mean, this guy's been pretty active, I gotta say, with the 3-bets and everything. Like, look at that. Yeah, fella is a bit out of line, I would say. It's a pretty good flop. Gonna size up just slightly. Just a little bit. Lots of bad turns here. Hope he just has a good old... Ooh! Boat Lero! Fuck, my stream deck is not attached. Merp. That was my boat sound right there. I'm gonna go really small here exploitatively because I want him to continue with all his draws. Maybe even raise them. I don't want him to fold like a queen check tape. We could also check turn. That's what I would do mostly versus like regulars, I think, versus a recreational, like another small bet. If you get up at 6 a.m. and grind till midday approximately, why don't you do a split session if you can hold consistent ROI and more volume equals more dollars? Why do you mean a split session? Like, split session doesn't make sense if you're playing MTT. Split sessions make sense when you play cash games or hypers or something like that. But I mean, MTTs, they take for 10 hours. How do you want to do a split session? Sometimes you grind for 6 hours, sometimes for 15. Yeah, that's an awful idea. And also, a split session is not more volume. I mean, it's obviously more volume because you play more hours, but just because you do a split... Generally, in a split session, you're going to play less MTTs total? It's definitely, like, you spend a lot of time. It makes much more sense just to fire one long session than split sessions in MTTs. I'm not sure where that idea comes from. I would love to do something with a 10-8 suited. It's a pretty good spot for him to open as well, yeah. But I don't know. Oh, sorry, this is my own like favorite song, so there's a bunch of German music in there as well. It's 10 to 3, but I mean, I guess I could just call this bar. I don't take it 4 ways pretty often. I saw an idea with the stacks though. Kind of feels like everything is fine there if you go for 3 bet a fold or flat. Wouldn't fault you for any of the 3 decisions as long as you don't 3 bet jam. Which could be fine again if he opens really wide. I don't think that's the case though. Party pooper blind levels are, yeah, it triggers me a little bit, but then again, like, they just want to offer something good, and the way they do is just by weird blind levels or whatever. Yeah. That's a good hand. So let's open it up. Stacks are pretty short at this point. I have 52 big blinds in the, as a chip leader. This is what you're one all in away from being a short stack. And busting in 7th. I'm not gonna bust in 7th, hey boys. I'm gonna fold aces preflop if I have to. I'm not gonna do that, but. Yeah. I'll start with the check. I think he's gonna have plenty of queen x in his range. Or ace high can just be good if he gets a showdown. Also, when I check here, any bets, and if you get there, you might expect me to have such good hand. We could check raise now. We'll just call. Feels like both options are fine. The sizing is pretty damn odd, I have to say. He might. Yeah, he probably has 8-7 here. Yeah, he has 8-7. Does he fold it if I raise? Probably not. Maybe he does. I don't know. Let's just call and see a good river. That's a pretty poor run out. He's going to check bet 8-7 of diamonds. What the f... Yeah, he says 8-7 and bets it. I guess I can't fold to the sizing though, because he has to be bluffing so few of the time. Queen check of diamonds, okay. Too bad. Don't think I should be folding the river given that price. Not much we can do. He gives me a great price to call on the flop. He gives me an amazing price on the turn and a pretty good price on the river, so not much I can do there. Though it takes a German to actually pronounce my name right. Usually English call me Gold. Are you Dutch? Gold, I don't know. But anyway, for next stream house, make sure you look on Airbnb. You get 20 to 40% off for longer stays, like several months. Yeah, we looked into Airbnb. I kind of enjoy the hype streams. I like it too, honestly. Much more energy. So yeah, not the best start to the final table. Nothing I can do with the Ace 10 of Hearts. I mean, I could re-raise the flop, jam turn, maybe fold his hand. But I'm pretty happy with the line I took. So we can win some pots here. Nice Cookie Monster. Good run though. Be happy with it and try to finish stronger next time. That's a great turn. He bets really small on the flop. Yeah, this is just gonna mean we have to decide what we do in the river pretty much if he bets the turn here. Not enough with this river. I'm just gonna bet third and hope he calls ace high. Let's go even smaller just to guarantee an ace high call. Yeah, pretty awful run out here. Och man. Not the best start to just find a table. What up, Lordrap? Doing great. Where's the bounty money? Right there. It's hidden. So you guys don't know how much money I already made. It's 800 bucks that I won in bounties already. Not a great final table start here. Like how I played the King 7. Actually lost the minimum against the King 10. Cool again. Was a great turn, but a really bad river. Whoops. Alright, I have to realize now that I'm clearly not the chip dealer anymore, so it's time for me to stay a little bit more patient. Look to get a ladder or two, try not to be overly aggressive. He has 11 BBs here. If he jams, we're gonna call. Not gonna be overly excited. He's been really, really tight so far. Let's just call it. I meant double session. Yeah, I understood what you meant, but it seems like an awful idea. You fuck up your entire schedule, your entire sleeping schedule. Alright, let's see a turn. Let's hope we finally get there with our flush draw. Yeah, it's pretty awful. Oh, that's so disgusting. Holy shit. I mean, I don't really think I can fold my hand here. Just hoping he has like 8-9 of clubs. But yeah, I think he usually just has ace, queen, ace, king here, and then we just need to hit. But with the clubs as an odd, him occasionally bluffing here. I think I can let this go. That's pretty disgusting. Yeah! Oh, that's a good hand to see. I guess he expects me to 3-bet like ace check plus preflop, so I only have like ace 10 that beats him there. Kind of a slow roll on my end for sure. Let's just limp along here. I mean, I can't really fold my hand there. It just reminds me of the King Queen of Diamonds, but deep in the melee. He's all in now, too bad. And A6, looks for a double KO. And that's it. Goodbye, boys. Not 7th place Lero. Woo! yay. Alright, let's go. That's a nice hand to see when he jams the turn there. I said he's been pretty tight. We got ace queen here, got 20 BB. I'm gonna go for the 3-bet call. I know he just has checks. Nah, but like he's gonna open more hands than. I mean, he has 6% of 180 hands, which is not ideal, but. Ace queen for 20. It's good enough. Would you ever bluff that river? Ace 10 of hearts? No, not really. I mean, yes, I would bluff that river, I guess, occasionally, but I don't like it too much. He's not folding a queen check if I ever jam there as well. I like check raising flop, but I don't like anything else pretty much. Maybe he could check jam turn as well. I wouldn't hate that. I don't like bluffing river. I like bluffing turn or flop or turn. I like an open here. We got the tightest person on the table in the big blind. We got recreationals and cutoff and button, most likely positions to flat. Yeah. So I don't hate playing a pot against them. He's been active with the three bets. Whew, the overcall. I mean, now I got a call and see a flop. Hopefully that flop includes two deuces. Oh, never mind. He's gonna... I mean, one of these two fellas like, is gonna call. Yeah, he's gonna call here. I'll be quite surprised to see a fold. There's the call. Let's see an ace. Ace! Alright. Save me a couple of chips there. I asked him about words, I forgot. A new word I learned was dull. Dull. Dull? Dull. Dull? Yeah. It's like when a knife is not sharp, the opposite of sharp is dull. I probably mispronounced right now because it sounds weird. I never really used the word myself, but now I know what it means. It can also mean lame. So this is not a dull final table, this is an exciting final table. There you go. Improving at the game of poker. Improving in the game of life. Improving my English. It's great. Yeah, because like, even though I live in the UK and I talk with the guys, obviously I speak a lot of English when I'm there. Still like a bunch of German that I talk, but here it's just me and like occasionally obviously I Skype with my family and then I speak German, but that's about it. So I guess I listen to some German music still. Oh, we had a KO here. Damn, Kran. That was a quick exit. Ace, queen versus kings, and what happened there? I'm gonna file a 3-bet here. This guy's definitely out of line. Alright, A7 just called down. Well, too bad, mate. Folded, Paul! You like opening wide and you don't like calling 3-bets. There we go. Now we're down to 5. Oops. We're back to the circus. Gotta call this mobman if he really jams here. Hope he doesn't. But I'm willing to invest a milli to win somewhere. Actually, it's kind of close because his bounty is like so insignificant. They could almost fold. That is my favorite outcome. I mean, he's not that inclined to regen too wide because of him. GG hype, yeah. And said goodbye to the circus. Ba-ba-ba. I mean, I definitely want to cash for 3k. I have to win it to cash for 3k, I guess. I mean, one more bounty in second place. Oh shit, kings versus queen 5. Whew, little sweat on the turn. Small sweat though. Did he limp that? There's no way he limped that, right? That would be pretty funny. It kind of looked like he limped it for a second, but there's no way he goes for 5 big blind limp there. In a situation where the big blind is never folding given... I mean, I guess he has a really small bounty. Well, he actually limped that, that's ridiculous. yeah, let's just see a flop. Over average flop. Man, he likes c-betting. I'm just gonna call here. If you want to raise here because you think he's over c-betting and you want to deny equity from random overcards, it's also fine. Definitely calling turn, obviously. Bottom pair might be good enough. We still got 8 outs to a straight. Too bad. And we called twice when we were ahead. We checked it behind when we were behind. Seems fine. I just streamed the bronze. There's no regular streaming schedule as of right now. Main reason for that is, as I said many times now, so sorry for the guys that heard it more just once now, as we see another KO. This is the first time in my poker career that I'm grinding peak time on the regular. Usually when I play in the morning, there's just so few tournaments for me to play that I did, like, every time I bust a tournament, I have to look for new stuff. And it's really not that tough for me to play only like 6 or 8 tables. But now that I'm playing peak time for the first time, it's just like such a new world for me. I play so many, like I play 12 to 15 tables, which is not that much for some people, it's a lot for others. It's just paradise for me, and I can't really justify streaming the whole session just because I play that many tables, and I love focusing on that. So what I'm going to do, I think, over the next weeks is just grind a shit ton of tables when I start my session and give you guys only like the best stuff, the deep runs, the fine tables, and yeah. So overall, there's going to be less streaming time, but higher quality. I think that's not bad for you guys either, because you only see really, really good stuff on this channel then. Yeah. So make sure to drop the follow button as well, just as I'm talking about this, because then you're notified when I go live, and you know you can be excited because there's a good run happening. I made schnitzel for the boys 2 days ago, actually. They loved it. The grind for weird blind levels continues as we're playing 65,130,000. What up, Trixie? Ooh, that's a good hand. And we still cover this guy, which is kind of nice. Just these little nuances, you know. If you have a 3-bet calls ace queen here, might pick up a $500 bounty. Off a flop, though. The opposite of sharp is blunt. I would use blunt also, lol. Oh, okay. They lied to me. I mean, they're Canadian, there's different, I guess there's different words for different locations. Let's see, dull. Or dull. Yeah, you can also say it for knife, just Google it. But the description of DFD as not dull would be adequate. Depends who you ask. Let's ask Prince Kenny what he thinks. I'm packing to leave Belgrade. Where are you going? Did you like check raise the flop here? I miss all the action that's happening on this fine table, man. Actually, I can just put the Twitch chat over here. Yeah, sure. There we go. So he wins the pot? Seems so. Alright. Gotta throw out another 3-bet here against him. A milli! See if he wants to play. I said he's just opening way too much and he's not calling enough 3-bets. So two good things. They make one 3-bet a lot. So you're gonna see a little bit of out of line 3-bets in some spots. Yeah, if you have certain opponents, that's gonna be the best play. As a general rule, I wouldn't recommend 3-betting 8-5 off from the big blind, but here it's definitely a profitable play. How's New Zealand? Fucking amazing. New Zealand is pretty amazing. Like, for a poker player, it's paradise. At least for me as a poker player. I'm a morning person now. Getting up at 6 a.m. and firing up a session and being done at like 3 p.m. and... yeah, and it's winter right now, and the winter is amazing, so I'm not even sure how the winter is going to be. My month of May, what month do we have right now? May. I'm up 30k in MTTs. I'm on a Power Fest for 25k. And some other stuff. Great month. I pricked for 1k's. Like the Scoop main event thing. But everything else is pretty amazing. I really want a 4-bet jam here. He's so out of line. I'm just going to 4-bet rip it here once again. If we run into it, we run into it, you know. But versus range, I think that's just the best play. Get back in your fucking cage, Paul. Trying to fucking 3-bet me, Paul. Alright, alright. Just to get a bit wild over there, man. Gets fucking 3-bed wrecked twice and then gets a 4-bed jam right into his face, man. Put him right back into his place. Let's go. Oh, he's coming in again. Alright. Would be funny if he folds now. He's gonna fold. I mean, he doesn't have a great hand here because I would be snap calling. And he's a bit out of line. Where's he from? Is he from Brazil? From Malta? Ooh. Also warm country, though. Whoa! Amigo! Hey, hey, hey. I mean, he might have gotten the... Oh, no, he has an $81 bounty. Yeah, I don't see. I like it. He is hard, though. Gonna make a note on that. Like, I always understand recreationals play like that. Has heart. Like, I think it's remarkable. Like, he just goes for it, you know? Like, he wants to gamble. He wants to put you in tough spots. And that's awesome. Like, I didn't love my spot there. 4-bet jam, he's 5. I like people that play like that. I've never really understood the recreationals. They're, like, super, super tight. I think it's, like, a style that I find tough to enjoy to play, right? But if somebody just goes for it, wants to put you in tough spots, wants to fuck you up, I understand that, so. Paul could be a guy I want to be friends with. Ooh, checks. I mean, I'm also a bit out of line here. There's a lot of green in my stats bar. yeah, we're just going through red call. I should probably size it up a bit more. Let's see if he finds the 4-bet jam with pocket hands. Good luck. Check! Yo! Boom! Those are the fucking moments, man! 13 millions on the FT. Big chip lead now. Whoa, what a flip, dude. Holy. Oh my god, I wasn't happy seeing Ace King there, man. I want to see the Ace Jack. Maybe an Ace Queen, you know, but like pocket tens. That's a tight flat preflop. I'm gonna check this back. I like to check back some hearts and some 9x. Oh, this is an awesome turn for me to bluff now. Just gonna bomb it. I have a lot of ace x when I check back the flop. So I'm just gonna fire here, fold it all 7x, 8x, king highs, queen highs. Maybe some check x even. Not a pretty spot for the check x. Ooh, we're gonna call? If I pray for the river to be a heart, because you won't expect me to have the heart, and then it's just paradise. Okay. If he bets here, I obviously have a snap fold because I have 9 high. If he checks it, I'm going to have to figure out a sizing. It's kind of tough for me to rep something. I just need to rep like ace-king, ace-queen. Whoa, hey! Hey! Party poker! What?! The software just fucking closed! What the fuck?! What?! Are they fucking kidding me? I have to reset the software. The software just fucking shut down. What the fuck? Hello, let me get back on my fucking final table. It takes forever to load up. Are you kidding me? The fuck was that? Oh my god, what the fuck? Are you fucking kidding me? That is just fucking ridiculous. Yeah, sorry guys, it's gonna be fixed in just a second. Wow. Wow. We fixed our fucking software. We fucking party. Oh man. Like, they wanna try do good fucking things, but like, it can't be fucking serious. The software just shuts down in like an important. Imagine if the river would have been a heart. Just imagine that. Holy shit. That got me fucking triggered. What the fuck? Like, I want them. And I just get too deep into that, but come on. Let's put the payouts back up. That is fucking ridiculous. Maybe they saved me some chips, because I would have bluffed it off, but not what I was hoping for, man. I wanted to bet small there. Represent the ace, king, ace, queen. Holy shit, dude. That's pretty ridiculous. If I would have made that flush, guys, I would have been so tilted. I can't even describe how tilted I would have been. Alright, so I bet the flop here. Turn is a bit close. I still kind of want to bet it. And then check back the river if you don't hit the club. Still gonna have like pocket eights that continue, 9-8, 7-8, ace-8. Could also check back, obviously. That's a pretty good river. As long as he doesn't have king, queen of clubs. Ayo, 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 ayo. Just hope he has 10-8 of diamonds. I'm not gonna be loving my life if he jams here. Alright. Holy shit. Wow, that's a kill bluff. I think I gotta call off this jam. $1,000 bounty. Don't have to pay that much. I mean, if he ices, I think I'm just calling, man. Look at all these shots, like, so, like, let's just gamble a little bit and get two bounties and double KO. My bounty is 850 right now. Weißen See und Udeka. Oh shit, let's go. Queen 9. Hold! Yeah! What a dream spot, man. Double life cuts. We heads up with the double KO. Shit. Let's do it, guys. Booty, booty, booty. Rocking every fucking wear. Can fick 16 Takte. Yeah. Alle sind unzufrieden, doch ich finde es eigentlich okay. Ich gucke manchmal in die Tues, um meine Feinde zu zählen. Krempel die Ärmel hoch, hab genug vom Gemecker. Geh raus, Sonnenbrille auf, es ist Bombenwetter. Alle sind unzufrieden, doch ich finde es eigentlich okay. Ich gucke manchmal in die Tues, um meine Feinde zu zählen. Krempel die Ärmel hoch, hab genug vom Gemecker. Sonnenbrille auf, es ist Bombenwetter. Keine Themen suchen, ich bin Klassiker. Freund Verschwörung, Turnschuhe, Praktiker, wird's weg. Wie geht's euch, meine Kleinen? Entschuldigung, ich war kurz unten am Teich, meine Keuchs passen. Danke, ich habe Teuschnupfen, bin ich ein gebildeter Typ oder ein eingebildeter Typ? Oder bildest du dir beides ein? Ich weiß, die primitive Prollschiene ist eine ziemlich sichere Goldmine. Und ihr folgt diese, ich glaub, Kinnladen runter. Okay, aber shut the fuck up. I need another song, man. This is a song I just can't listen to without singing to it. Alright, boys, this is how it's done. Big heads up match here for the bounties. Wait, let me click that shit. Party's getting an official complaint about that one. No bluffing allowed. They take care of me, man. That's like the gambling limit. Sir, you gambled enough. You bluffed too much. Not this time around. Did I just go for two streets and check back river? Maybe that would have been GTO. Oh, no, no. Actually, I should call probably. That's 3-5, 3-2. Should have thought a little bit longer. Did you win with 9 high, though? I did not. I mean, this guy's a regular note as well. I'm not sure why that is gone now after the restart. I mean, he was red before, right? I guess we just checked this. I have plenty of bluffs on the spot with 3-4, 4-5, and 3-5. Damn! Knight easy 3-bet here. Let's hope he 4-bet rip 6s. That was a sick disconnect, yeah. I mean, if the heart hits on the river, guys, I would be steaming. Get their attention. It's pretty big heads, I match. I mean, like 1.6k. I mean, over 3k now with this run. That's nice. Yeah, I will definitely clip that and tweet it at party. Henry Bühler on Twitter, guys. Link in description. Cheers. It's about to be legendary. Win the fight. That's a small 3-bet. Sadly, I have two small cards, so I can't call. Deuce. Woo! But that was sick. Until close party in his hand reaction. Exposed Lero. Let's bomb it. Just rip King Queen here. I'm not sure why you should rip it, but do that. Oh my god. Hey, too bad. I was hoping not to get snap called, and yeah, we didn't get snap called, but. Whoa. Set over set heads up is pretty absurd. Yo, cheers, Brownie. That was unfortunate. Let's see what the river brings. That's a good river. We win every time. Yay. Should have value bet there? No, I guess he could have like deuces, three fives. Hardy Barbie now, 45 BB. Okay, I like three bet here. But he raises up bigger this time, actually, let me just call. Tennis suit is pretty close. Like, we should always 3-bet, like, queen jack, I think, suited. Obviously not a heads-up expert. I wasn't singing, I was rapping, dude. It's a small turn bet. Oh. I don't know if I like this river or not. I guess I like it. Yeah, I speak German, English, a bit of French, and Latin. I can translate Latin texts. Not sure if that counts as speaking a language. I'm gonna fire two bullets here at least. Maybe even a third one. All right. Climbing back, guys, after that bad beat. Pretty deep, so making it a bit bigger here. Could triple barrel here. We'll see what happens. Let's start with a fairly small bet. And now I'm going to start with another small bet. We'll see if I've bombed the river. Actually, I'm going to size up slightly. Sitting with a nice river jam. Just hope he folds 8-9 here. Yeah, I'm not sure about the river if you should jam here every time. I think it's fine. Blocking ace, queen, ace, jack. Nice! Woo! Oh, let's go. You know you can make a D-heads up in party and you keep your own bounty? You can? Since when is that? Could get a change of title here. Whew, hearts, boys. I have heart. Just give up with check 9 here, mate. Yeah, he doesn't want to discuss it either. Back in the chip lead. Here's an $81 bounty, guys. Lol. Pretty mistakes now. When you go to make a deal, it won't show that you keep your own bounty, but you do, and you chop the prize money based on. I took a deal in this PKO on party, right, just a couple of weeks ago, and I got the entire bounty. So I'm not sure. Should I raise it here? Nah. Wo ich bin, wenn ihr mich so. Sorry, guys. I won't play this. Lots of German songs. That's just setup happens. Nah, it's not that big of a heads-up match. I'm confident, man. I think I've been playing like pretty good poker, especially when I'm one tabling, and I'm fine with a heads-up match. He might be playing more tables. I'm really confident in my skills, so I'm willing to play here. I mean, we're already back in the chip lead with that triple barrel with queen jack, so just get it. That set was so bad. How do you just shove there with flush there? That's horrible play. Being honest. Well, I'm being honest. I don't like you and I'm going to ban you. Something different if you argue about a play or if you just throw your opinion in the room by spamming. We can talk about it. The flush hits on the river. Yeah, it's not ideal anymore because there's some flushes that beat me now. We still want a value jam given that he has a bunch of two pairs. Hero calls in his range. Probably. Nice, man. We're doing good here. We're doing good, guys. Guys, ready to process the 10th place in a big tourney. Fire up a long study grind, fire up another session tomorrow. When you play MTTs, there's going to be lots of 10th place finishes, 11th place, 12th place, 13th place. The only thing you can do about it is fire it up the next day and not be the guy that whines about it for hours afterwards in Twitch chat. It's all about how quickly you can rebound, come back to your A game. See it as a challenge, okay? Poker tries to bring you down with the bad B. Poker tries to fuck you in the ass by sucking out in an important spot for you. But you're stronger than that. You're fucking better than that. You get back out there the fucking next day and you're getting that fucking win, okay? Alright? You're gonna work so much harder. You're gonna improve your game so much more that you're much more confident when you go deep. You're better prepared for the next fine table when you make it, okay? Just focus on it. Take everything you have that faces you as a challenge, okay? And the only goal you have is to overcome that challenge day after fucking day. Get it! I didn't know people still speak Latin, lol. I mean, I was in a weird school. We had Latin for 6 years. Wait, is he chatting or something? No, it's not. I could live today. BBs now. This bluff though, it's too advanced for me. My heart stopped beating every time. The thing about bluffing, every now you get caught and you look like a fool. But then if I value jam ace king there and he calls me with ace nine, I like my life. What can you do? Gotta bluff sometimes. We have a great bluffing candidate with queen check, blocking ace queen ace check. Which has best ace x to call. Nice. I mean, we're doing good against him. Heart of a lion. Gotta have a heart. Under 10 million for him, guys. Come on. Ooh. We'll generally size down slightly. That's just a 3x this time around. I should have gone a little bigger here. Yeah, that's how, like, my power fest deal was about a bit over a week ago. It was certainly a lot of my favor there. He likes these small leads, eh? How do you get to an FT with an $81 bounty? Masturbating a lot. Is that the answer to the question? yeah, we should very bet here. So he has queen 10 and calls. Ooh, I like it. That's interesting. I was close to checking back the river. Yeah, we call. Okay. I was just surprised he would lead the small in the turn with an ace, given that my range looks really strong. Gonna give him a check raise here. Got some nice backdoors. I think it performs better as a float. Or then a float. Nice. He also has an overcard. If he has a check, we have three clean outs. Just, or often we have three outs. Just make a better hand. Yeah, I probably should just c-bet more on these spots and then go from there. Yo, Morocco. Your cheers, Isa, for the link. For the clip. Morocco. Yeah, he probably plays multiple tables. You can see him, like, tanking sometimes. Which is, like, not standard. It's probably just because he plays more tables on the side. It's super fucked up for him. If you have multiple tables versus a guy that's just one tabling, you heads up. You're at a pretty strong disadvantage. Good job banning the absolute moron. I mean, I'm fine discussing hands, as I said, but if you have that attitude, keep being a losing player and... Oh yeah, exactly. Like, it's great for me, obviously, but he's never gonna take the deal. It feels like I'm scamming him when I do a deal like that. Yeah, I know, I know. I thought you said something different. I thought it would be like a fair bounty. Like, the way Party does the bounties is absolutely fucked. I mean, if people don't know about it, they just get massively scammed. $420, boys. There's a lot of like pairs with a like 3-5 here and shit like that. Wow. It's an unfortunate run out. Too bad. Just gonna use this to check raise again. Set over cards, back to flush draw. Just usually a nice hand to do with. Low spine for tournament, 2 cents. Sit and go on stars. I think I'm just giving up here on the turn. That's a pretty bad run up versus the King 10. Like on the flop, he actually a favorite in that hand. Now we gotta make the comeback. Oh yeah, now we can't take a deal anymore. I'm not getting to top 5 MTT players because I just don't know enough. I mean, he doesn't have it here. I hope he finds the triple bear bluff. He doesn't. I'm just gonna make a big here on the river. Nice. Little 2x over bet gets called. Feels good, man. Snap call by the check 6. Wow, that's a pretty unfortunate river for him. Good timing, Henry. Good timing. I'm gonna bluff the river here. That's a great river. Pretty easy for me to bluff all my check X now. I had to value bet all of my check X, even my 10X. Nice. Gotta go for another check raise. I get pretty big on the turn. Not ideal, but I'm gonna bluff, jam the river. Back in the Chipley, boys. Hard fucking Lero not here to fuck around, but we're here to battle and gonna turn this thing around. Let's go. Sure. We're only 99 HP because somebody donated a bit, and every time somebody donates bits or subs, he does damage to the current bit boss. Adrian Matthias? It depends. For example, Adrian is gonna be a pretty great player in a main event. I don't think he's gonna perform particularly well in the high rollers from what I've seen. So this is like also the reason, like it's tough to value players because there's different arguments for it. Do you want to rate somebody based on their live poker play? Do you want to rate somebody based on their online play? Do you want to rate somebody based on their high roller play or if they're the best in the main event? I would definitely give Matthias like top 3, if not top 1 spot in any main event. But if he plays a high roller, I would definitely take other people over him. Let's see about the river. I think he's going to check back the river a lot here. I don't like this river. Nice. We're doing good, guys. He had 7s. Max value. Not a nice hand to bet big. I like betting big on these spot textures. Nice, Mexican. Get it, dude. Yeah. Yeah, I know Queen B. I feel like it's not a scam, obviously. It's just an awful fucking idea to do it that way. Because people are not aware of it, right? If you expect to chop it, you expect to chop the entire price pool. I just think it's horrible. I'm gonna call Queen High on the turn. Yeah, he likes betting his hands more on turns, as I've seen before. Yeah, especially my sizing, I'm still gonna have some 2 pairs, I guess. Maybe not. Interesting heads up battle, man. Back and forth. Fun one. Yeah, pretty sure he's still playing multiple tables. How's the daylight over there? I'm currently in Auckland, New Zealand for the next couple of months, so just a different time zone. I like the 3-bet with pocket kings with 50% chip lead pre, just me. Yeah, probably just you. I hope so. Hey Henry, you're somewhat deep heads up and you have the second best hand in poker. Let's keep the pot small. Seems odd. Yeah, uptime is not there. Like for 1.5 hours. I'm gonna check back the turn and make a flush on the river. Never lucky. Not even once. Ooh. Oh, that's pretty interesting. Nice. To the one chip lead again. Like, this is why I'm so in love with myself, you know? Just because I just love myself so much, man. Just look at these plays, man. This is just good poker. Fucking sexy. Let's serve a sip of water for that one. Oh, Sandrax, 30 bits, dude. Thank you for that, mate. Sick bluff, man. Thanks, Fibonacci. Alright, gonna raise it up here. Please bet. So we don't run to aces, guys. aces is the only hand we lose to here. I guess king 8 and king 3 as well. It's pretty sweet. We almost have him, guys. Let's finish this out. Also, guys, if you're interested in my results, I'm going to post a graph of my yearly results for this year on my Instagram soon. It's Bolero on Instagram. Just drop a follow there if you're interested in that. I had a pretty successful year so far. If you want to see how I performed the online MTTs, make sure to drop a follow over there. All right, so hope he gets it in here with the 6-7 of clubs. He just folds. I take that as well. Ace King, I'm just going to open jam. Wow, you put weight on? Yeah, the last 3 days haven't been an idea with my diet. No, every now and then you gotta enjoy yourself. Gonna be back to normal diet soon enough. Actually, today I'm probably going for a run in the forest behind me. It's really nice. It's a nice chunk out there. There's little paths through it. I like going for runs there. Come on, let's close it out, guys. We had this insane cooler, fought back. 13 BB, I think we're just jamming. Let's get it. Hold. How? Four fucking outs. Bit annoying. Not gonna lie. We're really close there. I'm gonna crushing this heads up match. Not gonna lie, it's just good poker here. Exclamation mit Hot Stats, so sie da hat. Numbers. 20 BB deep now. We're really close to win there with the ace ten of clubs. Gotta continue to fight now. Let's hope we get a favorable run out here. Beautiful call, cheers. That was a nice one with the queen high. It's a small 3-bet. He hasn't 3-bet that much yet. Still in position, queen 9. Top 2 Lero. Let's put an end to this. Too bad. Sixteen BBs. Six. Pretty filthy. Just gotta keep on playing good poker. That's one of the. That's a pretty dominating heads up match in my favor. Would obviously be a shame to lose it, but that happens. Lots of variance in heads up poker. Just gonna stay calm. Keep playing good, solid, collected poker. And in the end, we should win more often than not. See your turn. Just gonna go for a small bet on the river. Pretty even now. It's never easy with the heads ups, man. It's never easy. Or we just fold king high. It's a pretty great river. To bluff. Adapt. Too bad. Didn't get the bluff through this time. Obviously, really great run out for me to turn my to keep bluffing with my 10-7. So happy with that. Good call by him with the ace as well. Sorry, more German music. Time is running out. Blinds are going up. It's a good song right now. It's a great turn. Na, good luck. Alright. Going on a break. Wow. Really, really happy with my play so far. Gonna take a quick break here, guys. You can use it as that Instagram.com/Bolero if you want to see what the year's result has looked like. I'm gonna post something soon there. I will quickly go to the toilet and then I'm just back in like, I don't know, a minute. So stay tuned. Hit the follow button here on Twitch as well. Let's get him after the break, okay? Come back. Expert rail tonight. Yeah. Haven't streamed in a while, so all of them are coming out. Actually, I could have been a caller. Ooh, he's playing quick. Twitch it sucks so negative. It's just some people, you know. Can't yourself be pushed down by them. Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ. Jesus Fibonacci. Yeah, I'm obviously, like, I don't care about that one guy. I'm a successful poker player. I made good enough money there. And I'm just getting started. Start from the bottom now we're here. Seven! Seven! Actually, I'm gonna raise this. I can like raise here. Seven! Nice. Thanks, Cold Deck J. I mean, I think we're playing great heads up match here. Right? It's tough to deny it. I mean, he sucked out like three times on me. And we're still in it. That's a pretty good sign. I checked it, as you can see here. Actually, yeah, I should uncheck it now. First time he double barreled. Well, it's your turn, river. Let's just slow him down. Nice. That's what I mean, like, we just win every pot post of and then we grind him down again. Hopefully it's good enough this time around to actually crush him. He made a nice hero call with these three. Can't discredit him for that one. But I think on all other fronts, I'm certainly playing better. See what happens here. Just winning. I have only 35 BB here. That must be wrong. Here's 34 BB. I think I'm just rejamming with 3 betting with 6s. GSN Rockets. Appreciate if that's a real comment from you. People are just trolling. It's Tonka. Just gonna check back river like so often here. Wow, what? Wow. Guess he expects me to never raise an ace. That's somewhat reasonable. Damn. A really small turn bet. Obviously can't fold. I mean, against this hand, we have six outs as well. Yeah, that's a good one. The reason I didn't stream to 24k win is just my OBS didn't work. I didn't have any audio, I didn't have anything like that. There was some issue on my computer. I figured it out afterwards, but it took me like a couple of hours. This is such small 3-bets, I probably should call 6-7 off. Picked pretty good timings for the 3-bet so far. He called the flop and turned to the river. I'm assuming he's calling. Wow. Wow. Well, next level poker from Hand Rockets here. So if somebody calls flop and turn, they always call the river. It's great to know. Appreciate it, man. Oh my god, Lord. That's pretty funny. That is pretty funny. Can't lie. It's like the one thing that you find the most in poker over any other sport. People that are like pretty delusional about their own skill set. Oh, that is like clearly awful. Oh, Fido with the check ten of clubs. He never calls birds in the river. Oh, it's really mind blowing. Right, let's see. Another summer storm. And he's probably best poker streamer. I'm not sure to be honest. There's definitely better streamers than me out there. I'm not sure if there's better poker players out there that stream. Got a call here. Duels on the river would be nice. Let's give some Russian timeouts here. Super Pliat boys. Not with me. Oh my god, fairly fortunate for him. Couple of times now. I don't like it, guys. I don't like it. I fucking crash and hits the fuck. It's pretty painful. Painful Lero. Oh man, that one sucks. That was a big pot. Too bad. Oh, he has aces. That's pretty odd. I'm not sure. Not 10 big blind heads up expert. 6-9 seems like a nice hand to see a flop with, though. I mean, you know, sometimes it's just not meant to be. Sometimes it's just not meant to be. We cash for 3,500, which is pretty nice. It's obviously a bit sad. Pretty happy about my heads up play there. We got four ordered when we got it with ace 10 versus king 9. What was the other spot where he sucked out on me? I mean, besides the final part. We obviously jammed ace 5 into his. Oh, yeah, we had the sick cooler with set over set. We jammed ace 6 into. Or ace 5 into ace check for 15 BB, which was unlucky. And then obviously the final hand. We get it in pretty damn good. He has four outs. Makes the runner runner two pair. You know, that happens. Really happy with my heads up play, man. I mean, we fucking crushed it. That was some sexy poker. I really loved that. Can't wait to get back on the streets tomorrow and play some more.